All right, ready to learn graphic design for newbies? Maybe you need graphic design, but you don't have the time, energy, or budget to learn Photoshop. This video can make anyone a graphic designer in less than 15 minutes. Seriously, let's get into it. What's up, busy people? Welcome to 5 Minute Social Media. If you have had figure out social media for my brand or business on your to-do list, and it keeps getting pushed down because you don't have the time, or you're overwhelmed, or you don't know where to start, you are in the right place. Every week, we release a quick video to help you with a different part of your digital marketing strategy. My name is Jerry Potter. Yes, it rhymes with the boy wizard. And today, we're helping out Deborah, who wondered where I make my YouTube thumbnails if I had somebody that she could hire to do that. My answer was, no, don't hire anybody. You can do it yourself. By the end of this video, you'll be able to do basic graphic design using a free program, and not only for social media, for flyers, posters, just about anything. These are all things that I've designed using Canva. I remember back in the day, somebody would tell me they knew Photoshop, and I'd be like, wow, that's really impressive. That's less true now. Now you can do so much great stuff using Canva, and you can do it on any computer in a web browser. On some computers, Photoshop takes like 5-10 minutes just to open the program.
So start off by going to canva.com. It'll pull up their login page here. You do need to create an account if you don't have one, but it's totally free. You can also create your account with a Facebook or a Google account. So this is the screen you'll see when you first log in, and the first thing you have to decide is, okay, what am I going to create? So you see create a design here. You can start by clicking on that, and it'll bring up all of these different templates. So at the top are some of the most popular ones, a Facebook post, A4 letter size, a program, a desktop wallpaper, social media, which is just a generic 800 by 800 pixel. So all of these are kind of the most common ones. And then you scroll down, you'll see all kinds of other things you can choose. A square social media graphic. Of course, you can do an Instagram post here. These are all pre-sized for what you need. Presentations, letters, letterhead, magazine covers, book covers, ebook covers, logos, all kinds of stuff. So what you can do is go through here, Etsy shop cover, Etsy shop icon, find what you're looking for. If you can't find exactly what you need, you can come up here and click Use Custom Dimensions, and then you can put in whatever numbers you happen to want for whatever you are creating. So just to show you some of the stuff that's in here, I'm going to go ahead and click on Magazine Cover, because why not be fancy? And the first thing it'll do is it'll bring up all of these different layouts for magazine covers. So you can actually just take one of these and then change it to something else. So let's say that, I like this one. So you click on it, it has different layouts for different pages within the magazine. So let's click on the cover. Now I can double click on the text and change it to whatever I want. So you can see the text went a little low there. I can come up here, I can change the text size to something smaller. If I want to move it, I can just click on the graphic, move it around the screen. If I wanted it to be a different color, I can make it red if I want. I would never do that. Looks terrible, but you get the idea. You can also, if you clicked on an image, you could crop the image by clicking crop. There's just all these features, and they're all right there on the screen for you. That's what makes it so easy. I want to take you back to the beginning again. Let's say instead we want to make a graphic for Instagram. So I'm going to click on Instagram post instead. So Instagram posts are 1080 by 1080 square, and you've got all of these preset designs that you could choose one. So let's say you have somebody who loves pizza. Boom, here you go. It's a Valentine's Day card. It's already done. You don't need to do anything. Now, since this is a fake website, you might want to take that off so you could highlight it and then click up here on the trash can. Boom, that's gone. And then you could replace it with something else. So I'll show you how to kind of build around these in a second, but I just wanted to show you a few of the layouts before we get into the building part. Let's say next, you wanted to create a Facebook ad. Here's a template for that. Now you can go through and use one of these, or if you want to make your own thing, you already have the sizing done right here. So I want to take you through the different menu elements here. So layouts is where it will go by default, because a lot of people just like to start by using a template that somebody else created. And you can see all of these ones I'm showing you right now are all free. You can take them and make them yourself. A lot of times what I'll do is I'll find one and go, oh, that's really neat looking. I don't want it exactly like that. That kind of gives me an idea, and then I'll build mine from that. So that's what's under layouts here. If you go to Elements, this is where you can add all sorts of different things. They have free photos. These are all free photos that you can use. If you would like to search, you can also search for photos. So let's make it a motivational quote. So I'm going to search for landscape. Lots of landscapes here. I click on one that I want. It automatically shows up here, populates the window. Then I can drag it to the corner, and then I can drag the corners to resize it to fill the space. You want to make sure the resolution is high enough, of course. Boom. Now I've got an image there. Now, if you will see some of these say $1. All of the images that are not free, you can buy in here for $1, and you can edit them up to 24 hours. Considering a lot of stock photo sites cost 10 bucks for like the cheapest image, a buck is a pretty good deal. If you only wanted to see photos, click photos. If you only wanted to see illustrations, you can click illustrations. So, also under elements, there are grids. So if you wanted to divide this up a certain way, if I click on this, now it's put a grid on there, and I could drag three separate photos and they would automatically pop right into place. Frames, add frames to your pictures and different designs. Shapes, if you wanted to add a shape, solid or transparent. Different lines. So you can click on all these things, and these are all different things that you can add to your image anytime you want. So let's put a hot dog on the landscape. Sure, why not? I want to rotate it. I'm going to click on this arrow. It's getting weird, isn't it? Now there's a hot dog floating in the sky. Icons, if you're making an infographic or just need something to spice it up, these icons also, not only can you use them, but then you can come up here and make them any color that you want. Charts, if you're trying to make a chart, you can put a chart in here. Click on data, and you can actually change the data. So if you're making a presentation or something like that. Down below that, you can choose text. Let's get rid of this light bulb here. We'll keep our hot dog in the sky. And so if you want to add text, right here, you can just simply click on any of these, and it will add it to the middle of it by default. Or if you want to use one of these fun designs down here, you can add stuff that's already designed like that. Again, there's just so many pre-made pieces that you can use and customize as your own. So obviously this black doesn't look very good on here. So first I'm going to make this white. After you change the color, you can change the font. You can change the justification, the spacing, all kinds of different things. You can also, if you want to, up here on any element, is you can make it partially transparent. So it kind of lets you blend things in a little bit there. Below text, over back on the left, we have background. This is if you want to choose a background or a background color. So let's go ahead and just get rid of the pictures that we have. And maybe instead we want to have just a blue background, green. Or there's different patterns down here you can choose if you're designing something. Lots and lots of free ones. There are some at the bottom that cost a dollar if you wanted to make something special with them. And then finally below that, you have uploads. And this is where you can upload your own images to make a graphic out of. So I can drag any image here on upload. You see it's going to upload, and as soon as I want to use it, I click on it. Once you have everything all set the way you want it, you can come up here to share if you want to email it to somebody to look at or anything like that. Or if you want to download it to put into Facebook or one of your scheduling software programs or to print. I've done posters in here. Come up here, choose your file type, the pages that you want, hit download, and off it goes. And if you did choose any of the paid images that you had for a dollar, this is where it'll say, okay, this is going to cost you a dollar. Is that okay? And then you can pay for it. It really is easy for anybody. And I want to show you a little secret, actually. I've never told anybody this, but I'm going to click on logo. And I actually made my 5-minute social media logo just by taking a template that was here in Canva and then tweaking it. I think I started with this one here and then played around with it until I got my 5-minute social media logo. If you need any help, Canva has incredible support on all sorts of different things. So there is plenty of help available to you. Jump in there. The best thing to do is choose a size, jump in, look at the templates, and start playing around.
Once you've used Canva, you're going to wonder, how in the world can this program be free? This is so cool. Well, of course, there is a paid version that starts at $9.95 a month. And here are some of the things that you get with the paid version that are not available in the free version. You get lots more free photos, illustrations, and templates. You can use what they call magically resizing your design. So if you design something for Instagram and you wanted it for Twitter, it'll automatically resize it. You can upload custom fonts. If your brand uses a font that's not found in a lot of programs, or you're a font nerd like my wife is, then this is a really cool tool to have. You can download your designs with transparent backgrounds so then you can apply them to other images or place them over videos. And you can export designs as animated GIFs. And by the way, Canva's not only on computers, but they've got pretty slick apps for both iPhones, iPads, and Android devices. So jump into Canva. By tomorrow, you can call yourself a graphic designer. Well, maybe. We'll see. You got a question? Leave it down in the comments or join our private Facebook group. Just search 5-Minute Social Media on Facebook. Or I've got the link down in the description below. Would love to chat with you there. I'm in there every day. If you got something out of this video, please give it a like. It helps the channel, helps me grow. Hit subscribe, click the bell so that you know when new videos come out. Thank you for supporting me, but also my two tiny superheroes at home.